United Church of Christ. Are on life's journey, you're welcome here at the First Reformed Church. And for those that are watching online, we say good morning to you, whether you're viewing from your living room, your kitchen, or your bedroom, or you're at home, or wherever you may be watching on your smartphone, whoever you are, wherever you are on life's journey, you are also welcome here at the First Reformed Church. I pray that you are blessed on this crisp fall morning as we begin with our call to worship. If you're able to, we'd ask that you would stand where you see the asterisks, please. Come share the joy of the Lord. Praise God, who gives each person a special gift to be nurtured and shared. Come, let us worship God who entrusts us with so much. Lord, make us worthy your love and trust in us. Our opening hymn, God of Grace and God of Glory, and you're welcome to read along for reflection or hum our opening hymn. Inspiring, challenging, and creating are all among the myriad of things you've placed in our lives. Direct our lives to use these gifts as we reach out to our neighborhood and nation, witnessing to your love and your healing mercy, O Lord, our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. The Bible reminds us that the God that we serve is faithful and the God that we serve is just to forgive us of our sins. And so this morning we are led in our prayer of confession taken from Philippians 3. Lord of mercy and justice, you've given us so many talents and gifts to be used in your world. You've given us these gifts because you trust us to use them well. And you will be with us in all our work. But we disappoint you when we denigrate the value of the talents or become so fearful of failure that we don't believe that we're capable of helping in this world. Lord, forgive us. Help us to trust in the gifts you've given to us and to trust in your guidance in using them. Forgive us when we are fearful, stubborn, apathetic, indifferent to the needs around us. Give us hearts for serving you all our days. This is our prayer. Amen. Hear now the words of assurance. Rejoice and celebrate. God has placed God's trust and love deep within your hearts. You have been called and trust to serve God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen. Something to pass the peace among one another of God. Glad to see my partner in crime today. Pastor Dana is with us. Glad to see him. Hello to Larry. Bill and Bill and Brenda are holding down the fort in the balcony. That's the VIP section. Amen. We're now going to be blessed with an organ solo. To you, Jehovah, will I sing. You may be seated.
morning. Bear with me here. This is a pretty long reading and a lot of tough words. The first reading is from Judges, chapter 4, verses 1 to 7. Again, the Israelites did evil in the eyes of the Lord, now that Ehud was dead. So the Lord sold them into the hands of Jabin, king of Canaan, who reigned in Hazor. Sisera, the commander of his army, was based in Harosheth-Hagoyim. Because he had 900 chariots filled with iron and had cruelly oppressed the Israelites for 20 years, they cried to the Lord for help. Now Deborah, a prophet, the wife of Lebadah, was leading Israel at that time. She held court under the palm of Deborah between Ramah and Bethel in the hill country of Ephraim. And the Israelites went up to her to have their disputes decided. She sent for Barak, son of Ephraim, from Kadesh in Naphtali, and said to him, "The Lord, the God of Israel, commands you. Go and take with you 10,000 men of Naphtali and Zebulun, and lead them up to Mount Tabor. I will lead Sisera, the commander of Jabin's army, with his chariots and his troops to the Kishon River and give him into your hands." The psalm this morning is Psalm 123. It is a song of ascent. I lift up my eyes to you who sit enthroned in heaven. As the eyes of slaves look to the hand of their master, as the eyes of a female slave look to the hand of her mistress, so our eyes look to the Lord our God till he shows us his mercy. Have mercy on us, Lord, have mercy on us, for we have endured no end of contempt. We have endured no end of ridicule from the arrogant, of contempt from the proud. And the gospel this morning is from Matthew, chapter 25, verses 14 to 30. It's the parable of the bags of gold. Again, it will be like a man going on a journey who called his servants and entrusted his wealth to them. To one he gave five bags of gold, to another two bags, and to another one bag, each according to his ability. Then he went on his journey. The man who had received five bags of gold went at once and put his money to work and gained five bags more. So also the one with two bags of gold gained two more. But the man who had received one bag went off, dug a hole in the ground, and hid his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants returned and settled accounts with them. The man who had received five bags of gold brought the other five. "Master," he said, "you entrusted me with five bags of gold. See, I have gained five more." His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things, and I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness." The man with the two bags of gold also came. "Master," he said, "you have entrusted me with two bags of gold. See, I have gained two more." His master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness." Then the man who had received one bag of gold came. "Master," he said, "I knew that you were a hard man, harvesting where you have not sown, and gathering where you have not scattered seed. So I was afraid, and I went out and hid your gold in the ground. See, here is what belongs to you." His master replied, "You wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvested where I have not sown, and gathered where I have not scattered seed? Well then, you should have put my money in deposit with the bankers, so that when I returned, I could receive it back with interest." So he told them, "Take the bag of gold from him and give it to the one who has 10 bags. For whoever has will be given more, and they will have an Whoever does not have, even what they have, will be taken from them. And throw that worthless servant outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. God, we thank you was working, now it's off. I don't know. While she's bringing me a mic, it was fun and I just went up. Having little technical difficulties, we'll be right there. Now it's gonna work. Of course, when you get down here, it's gonna work. So I just wanted to see how fast you could run down the steps. That's all. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry, sir. I know as soon as you got down here, it was gonna start working, but I timed you at a good time, so yeah, just leave it. Yeah, that'll work. All right. Okay. I'm putting it back in my pocket. I don't know. When I wear my robes, it acts up. All right, let's pray. God, we thank you for revelation knowledge that will flow freely, unhindered and unrestricted from any type of forces. We thank you, God, that our eyes are anointed to see, our ears are anointed to hear, and our hearts are anointed to understand. And we thank you, God, that our lives will be made the better as a result of the word we hear today. So, God, I pray that they not hear Devin, but that they hear you, that they not see Devin, but that they see you. And God, if there ever was a time that I need you right now. Thank you even now for the word that will fall on good ground. It's in your name I pray, amen. Now, if you notice on last week, one of America's TV icons passed away. He wasn't just known as a father or as a husband or as a friend or as someone's big brother or uncle, but he will be best remembered as the host of America's game show Jeopardy, Alex Trebek. And Alex Trebek died from a long battle with pancreatic cancer, but one of the things that Alex Trebek shows you and I is that it's not how you die, but it's how you live. My grandmother would always say to me that, Devin, it's not necessarily how you die, but how do you live? We all have a start date, but then we all will also have an end date. And the thing is, what do you do with the dash that's in the middle? And it is there in the middle that God uses our talents, our times, and our treasures. For you and I must understand that God is the giver of all things. And everything we have is a gift from God. And whatever it is that the sovereign will of God gives us, we are expected to be good stewards over what we possess. God holds us accountable for what we're going to do with what God has given us. The word steward, Terry, literally means a house manager. So we are managing God, we are managing from God what he has entrusted us with. We are all house managers, managing what God has entrusted us with. Come up close and look at the gospel text. The text Teresa read for us today introduces us to the parable of the talents. Before I begin, I wanted you to take out a pen and cross out, you see my title, FRC Got Talent. Cross out the God and say FRC Has Talent. I said America's Got Talent, FRC Got Talent, so you understood why I did it. But Linda, it bothered me all weekend when I looked and said I should have said FRC Has Talent, not FRC Got Talent. Anyway, back to the sermon. So anyway, the parable of the tenants, we see that there is an owner that is going away. He's going away and he gives the servants bags of gold. One servant, he gives five bags of gold, and you guys saw the story. The one with the five took it and doubled it and ended up with 10. One got two bags, and he went and he invested his and was able to get four more bags. But the one that only received the one talent did not invest their one talent, but instead they buried the talent. And I didn't come this morning to preach to everybody, but I came this morning to talk to the people that have buried it. You buried your talent, you buried your time, you buried your treasure. You say, well, Pastor D, what are you talking about? I didn't dig up anything and bury anything. No, you bury it when you think that talent that you have is insignificant, where even it may not be as greater as the one that is sitting to your left or your right, but we all understand that it's not equal giving, but it's equal sacrifice. And because of the pandemic, because of an economic crisis, because of different things, some of us have, Jim, buried our talent, buried our treasure, bury our time. Believe it or not, some people haven't given the entire year to First Reform. Some people have fulfilled their pledges and some people have not, and some people share, Pastor D, I wish I could, but because of what's going on economically, I can't give the way that I used to. That's understandable. But what about of your time? Tuesdays, you're welcome to come and help, even if it's not our day to serve the meal. Saturday mornings, you're welcome to help. You're welcome to call Janet or I and say, hey, is there anything that we can do to help out with Fulton Elementary? All of us at some point of our lives can be honest and say, Pastor, I'm guilty. Instead of using it, I buried my time, I buried my treasure, and I buried my talent. And the good news is this. I'm not so much trying to beat up on the ones that buried their talent, but I wanted to interview him and ask him specifically, why did you bury your talent? You had it, you could have invested it, you could have did something with it, but instead you buried the talent. You buried it. And I believe if he was alive, he would say to me, well, Pastor D, I did not think what I had was significant. I'm not able to give hundreds and hundreds of dollars. I only can give a little bit. I don't think it's significant. I work a lot, so I can't volunteer on Tuesdays and Saturdays the way I would want to, Pastor D, but I can donate some cereal, I can donate some milk, I can drop off a couple of dollars to help with the meal. Understand, beloved, that there's nothing too small of your time, your talent, and your treasure that you can give. Whether it's 5 minutes, whether it's 30 minutes, whether it's $30, whether it's $300, God is not impressed with the amount, but God is impressed with whether you are faithful with what God has given you. And so, I'm sure you've heard the phrase that clenched hands can't receive anything, but open hands can be filled. And God wants us as a body of believers, as a community, to be people that aren't burying our treasures, our time, and our talent, but instead we give what little we can, because every little bit can help us out. You started with us in our dialogue the last couple of weeks as we've traveled through the gospel text. We started off learning how we can be and the attitudes that we should have. Then that next week we came together and you were encouraged to keep your lights on, keep that love of God showing, that we need to make love great again in America, that what the world needs now is more love. And during all of those sermons, our dialogue, we could see that Jesus was telling us to be prepared, telling us to be watchful, telling us how to conduct and carry ourselves. But notice it goes from now watching to working. That what I've given you, you have to do something with what I've entrusted you with. You have to do something with what I've placed in your hands. And so the question is, what are you doing with what God has blessed you with? That time that you have, that talent that you have, that treasure that you have, what are you doing with what God has blessed you? Right now, we need to live in the present, but we have to begin to think about the future. That is why I believe those other servants, Teresa, invested their talents, because they weren't so much living in the present, but they were thinking about the future. So last Sunday, I gave you all of these P's, and as we go to Pledge Sunday on next week, I want you to prepare. I want you to plan. I want you to pray about it and even practice writing that $1 million check. You understand? No, don't practice writing it unless you can write it. You understand? I want you to get in the habit of it. Why? Because you're good stewards in the kingdom of God. So if we're supposed to give God our best, we're supposed to give God our best, exactly what is it that God is looking for? I'm glad you asked. The first thing that God is looking for from us as servants is God is looking for your availability. Your availability. Your availability. Are you available? Do you have what? Time to showcase your talent, to showcase your treasure. Do you have the availability? Benjamin Mays has a poem and he says it like this: I only have a minute, 60 seconds in it. Forced upon me, I did not choose it, but I know that I must use it. Give account if I abuse it, suffer if I lose it. Only a tiny little minute, but eternity is in it. And I don't know about you, but the older that I am, you want to know a pet peeve of mine? Please don't waste my time. Anybody else like that? The older you get, you cherish your time. Don't call me with foolish stuff. Don't talk to me about something crazy. Don't waste my time. It's very precious. Anybody else feel like that about time? You feel like your time, one person does. I see, okay. That you feel your time is very precious. And so we have availability that we can give to God. But also, there's also not just availability, but it is your ability. Notice what I said. It's not just your availability, Phyllis, but it's also your ability. Notice this. A talent is a measure of money. It's not an ability, but it applies just the same. In each case, everyone got a different amount, but all got a lot, even if less than the other. For instance, the one with 5 talents got about 100 years' wages. The one with 2 talents got about 40 years' wages, and the one with 1 talent was about 20 years' wages. And when you look at it from the text in this view, you can see that the Lord is our master and that we are his servants. And the talents represent our abilities. The talents represent our possessions. The talents represent our opportunities to serve the Lord. So FRC, you don't got talent, you have talent. You have time and you have treasures to use for the Lord. And the key, again, is not how much you have, but how faithful you are with what you have. Every one of us has been given something, and each of us have something in our hands, and we can all serve God in some way. And we're all different because we are a body, and each other, one of us represent a different part, but all of us have to work together to get things done. We're interdependent upon one another. We need each other. And when you aren't fulfilling, when you aren't filling your place, there's a hole that's there. There's something that's missing that's there. There's something that could have been filled that's there. Many of us, I'm almost close, can do great things that others cannot do. And some of us can do things that we were designed and trained for, but all of it is necessary. Not only do God look at the servant's availability and looks at the servant's ability, but the last thing that I see that the text shows us is that it shows us the servant's activity. That in other words, the servant got to work. And in verse 16, the servant went to work. In verse 17, the servant was faithful. Don't expect God to give you more until you are faithful with what you've got. Do what you know, then watch God make it grow. And so that's what God is calling us to, First Reformed. Maybe you buried it. Maybe you say, well, I'm going to wait till the pandemic is over and then I'll give my pledge. No, don't wait till the pandemic is over. Fulfill that pledge. Hey, well, I can't give like I used to, but you donated cereal, you donated milk, you donated juice, you donated time. Thank you for your treasure. Thank you for your time, and thank you for your talent. Are you using your talents? Are you using your treasures? Are you using your time wisely to do what God has called you to do? So maybe you've buried it, but the God of grace is allowing you time. I wish I had a shovel up here to go get your shovel and dig up that time, dig up that treasure, dig up that talent, because God's kingdom is in need of it. So as you prepare, as you pray, as you plan on your pledges for next week, begin to think about your treasure, your time, and your talent. How can I be a blessing to my church? How can I be a blessing to the community's endeavors that our church is involved in? Because we are blessed, First Reformed, because we do. We have talents. We all possess something great and something powerful that can be used to change lives. So God, we give you our availability. God, we give you our ability. And we give you our activities. We pray, God, that it will all be used for the upbuilding of your kingdom. We pray, God, that we are good stewards over what you've given to us. And just as Alex Trebek lived a full life, we pray, God, that we too would live full lives. God, someone needs our talent. Someone needs our treasure. Someone needs our time. God, we thank you for opportunities to give back to you. It's in your name we pray. Amen. Amen. We have any joys and concerns?
I don't know if anyone realized or has seen the information that we would like to make our courtyard between the church and the education building a Christmas decorated area. Next Sunday, the 22nd, after church, we will be doing that. And we are looking for people who would like to help do it, people who would like to maybe bring Christmas decorations they're not using, or if you want to go out and buy something to donate, or give us money to go get some lights or something to help decorate the courtyard. We would like to have the courtyard as a beacon of light and hope and happiness for the neighboring area. And maybe people come in from outside of the area to come and see what we have displayed. We already have someone who is bringing in a Mary and Joseph and baby figurine. We have the stable that Bob had made years ago that we used, and we're going to have that out there and put out a couple Christmas trees. It just sounds like it would be a very nice place for people to walk through and to enjoy during the holiday season. So if you would like to be involved in that, just let me know next Sunday. Thank you.
We're decorating the courtyard, so if you have old Christmas items, holiday items in your garage, in your attic, in the basement. You know you guys are hoarders. You know you got stuff. Bring all of that stuff in and we could display it in our courtyard. And I thought it would be a great light, a great testimony to the kids in the community because they don't have to go all the way out to the county to see lights. They can just come down to East Orange Street and see lights. So please, ma'am, please, sir, if you can, bring something. And then also, it's a double whammy, I'm sorry. Also, Christmas is coming up, and so we want to give an unwrapped toy to a boy or girl ages from grades 5 to 12. So when you go out shopping, if you've already done your shopping, buy something extra for another kid. It was brought to my attention that we are with Amazon, oh Lord, help me say it, Amazon Shine, what is it, Star, what?
Smile,
thank you, I couldn't remember. Amazon. Jim Chris was showing me, but I couldn't see because he had his mask on, he was going like that. But it's Amazon Smile. And so one of our members said, if you guys buy your toys from Amazon Smile, then the church gets part of the proceeds. So that's another option that you can do. We just want to be a blessing to the community, Anyone else? Again, next Sunday is Pledge Sunday, so please, ma'am, please, sir, govern yourselves accordingly and begin to think about what it is that I can do for God in this next year as it relates to my time, my talent, and my treasure. How can I serve my church? How can I serve God? And it's not how much, but it's how faithful you are with what you give. All right, let's pray. God, we thank you that it's in you we live and move and have our being. We thank you, God, for this day, a day that we've never seen before. And God, we pray that you would help us to be good stewards over all that you've given us, the time, the talent, and the treasures that you have blessed us with. We pray that we will be good stewards with our availability, the time that you've given us, God, help us not to waste it. Not only our availability, but our ability. Some of us have 5 bags, some have 2 bags, some have 1 bag. God, someone doesn't have any bags. But we thank you, God, that it is not how much, but it is how faithful we are with what you've given us. But then, God, we also pray that you would help us with our activity. That everything we do, let it give you glory, let it give you honor, and let it give you praise. And God, today someone needs you to be a waymaker. Someone needs you to be a healer. Someone needs you to be a deliverer. Someone's loved one was diagnosed with COVID. Someone has faced being terminated from their job. Someone is going through a divorce. Someone is sitting in a jail cell. God, whatever it is, whoever they need you to be, God, thank you for being that God. Thank you for doing it for Deb, for Darlene, for Rob, for Clara, for Joanne, for Kathy, for Mary Jo, for Pat and Sue and Arlene and Kay, for Yvonne and Ron and Janet and Janine, for Dora and Shirley and Paula and Kathy, for David, for Noreen and Mike, for Ed, for Bill, for Bruce, for George, for Ed and Dorothy, for Jackie, for Amanda, for Oliver, for Tom, for Scott. Oh God, for those that have loved ones or friends that have been diagnosed with COVID, for those that are waiting in quarantine for results, for those, God, that are in hospital rooms, that are on ventilators, God, we thank you that you are still a healer, that you are still a deliverer, and that you're still a redeemer. And we pray this morning the way you taught your disciples to pray, in saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. And again, next Sunday is Pledge Sunday. Govern yourselves accordingly. For those of you that have given, thank you for your time, thank you for your treasure, and thank you for your talent. For those that have not given, pray and ask God to lead you in your giving, because FRC has talent. Our closing hymn is We Are Called to Be God's People. You're welcome to read along for reflection or hum. We're called to be God's people.
Thank you.
stand so we can be dismissed? May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord be gracious unto you. May the Lord lift up their countenance upon you and give you peace. Peace in the name of the Father, peace in the name of the Son, and peace in the name of the precious Holy Spirit. God, speak to us this week as it relates to our time, our talent, and our treasure. Show us where you're working and allow us to join you there. In Jesus' name.